But first, Roger begins with Victory, starring Sylvester Stallone.
Victory is a new escape thriller that seems to have been deliberately knocked together out of the best parts of several old movies. It's sort of like The Great Escape meets The Longest Yard and Rocky. Just check off these basic ingredients: an escape from a prison camp, a dramatically important soccer match, and a one-on-one showdown between Sylvester Stallone and a fearsome opponent. Once you realize where the plot elements of Victory are coming from, we're pretty much able to predict what's going to happen in this movie, and we're pretty much going to be exactly right. Victory is set in a World War II prison camp in Germany. A group of Allied prisoners start a soccer team with Michael Caine as the coach. Stallone is the guy who tries to play soccer as if it were American-style football.
Hey, Fowler! Stupid bloody yacht! What the hell do you think this is? Bloody hell.
Well, what'd I do?
You know bloody well.
Now, you tell me, what'd I do?
You cannot tackle like that in soccer. I've been telling you that for a bloody year.
I was just going for the ball.
You use that bloody American style again here and you'll be barred.
Look, you play English, I play American.
Well, don't play the bloody American game. Get off! Shoot, Lovey!
Where'd you learn to do that?
When I was a boy. In Trinidad. On the street with the oranges.
How'd you like to play football against the Germans?
That's the great soccer star Pelé, the kind of guy Caine wants on his team. But Stallone keeps trying to make the team because he has escape plans.
You're not on this team.
Well, sure I am.
I just want to be around the guys.
No.
Don't do this to me.
I don't need a con man.
Mr. Corby, the only way out of here is by being on that team.
No.
Why not?
I won't be responsible for your death. You get yourself shot.
That's my choice, isn't it?
Okay.
There's a nice dry authority there from Michael Caine. Stallone, the brash American, fast talks his way onto the team, and in this scene, Caine and Pelé give him some practice.
We've got a good bunch out there. These guys are coming along real fine. I think the Germans are going to have to go some to beat them.
You're an optimist.
Well, what are you?
That's not bad, Hatch.
What's not bad?
Using your hands.
You've got feet, I've got hands.
Yeah. Give me that. Get in there.
Sure thing, General.
Lewis. Lewis? Fire a few at him.
I gotta do better than that. Come on, you guys, let's fire him in here then. Here we go. Oh, yeah, here we go. Come on, put it.
Give me some balls, Charlie.
Oh, you're gonna get serious now, huh?
Okay,
then. Okay, guys, come on, fire him in here. Let's go, right? Let's go. Come on, don't be afraid of me. Oh, yeah, what? Fast. Whoa! Right there a minute. Come on, yeah.
Can you do it with your mouth shut, Hatch?
Hey, the mouth and the hand work together. It's a team. Come on.
Get your body behind it.
Come on now.
Not like that. Like that. Hands behind it. Pull it into the chest.
Oh, where is that?
Come on, Hatch. I want to see now.
Let's go. Come on, right down the middle.
I thought you were my friend.
I am your friend. You know, Hatch, to be honest with you, you don't kick well. You don't dribble well. But you could be a good goalkeeper. Keep trying.
Thanks a lot.
I may be wrong, but I have a lot of trouble believing that in 1944 the Nazis were supplying practice uniforms and extra soccer balls for their prisoners. Anyway, later on, that Allied soccer team is ordered to play an exhibition match against a Nazi team in a stadium in Paris. Stallone escapes from the camp to go to Paris to arrange a halftime escape for the entire Allied team. He falls in love while he's there with a young French woman, and then he goes back to Germany and breaks back into the prison camp in order to tell everybody what the plan is. I hope you're following all of this. Mm-hmm. It leads up to the movie's three-way interlocking final plot showdown. Part one, will the Allies beat the Nazis? Part two, will they try to escape at halftime? And part three, will Stallone be reunited with a French girl that he loves? But what happens then? Well, if you've seen The Great Escape, The Longest Yard, and Rocky, let's put it this way, the movie's not going to have a whole lot of surprises for you.
I found this a very enjoyable film, so we disagree here. I think the kind of picture that you're talking about, The Great Escape and The Longest Yard, I think this is that kind of audience picture where there's an attempt by the director, in this case John Huston, to simply take the audience through an old traditional formula, the building of the team, and then the final confrontation. I liked your remark about World War II Germany. I think this is a very sanitized version of that. That disappoints me, honestly. But I thought this was a very pleasing picture. I got caught up in the most fundamental way that movies work on people. I was rooting for the good guys.
Well, I don't think this is a major disagreement. I cannot recommend the movie, but I can understand what you're saying, and I did hear the people in the theater cheering during the soccer match, and I enjoyed it to a certain degree myself. One thing, maybe from a sociological point of view, that was kind of interesting, at halftime, and I'm not going to give away the ending of the movie, but at halftime, they've got to make a choice. Should they go back out there in the second half and beat the Nazis, or should they escape? And I think that the 1940s and 1950s movie audiences would have said, go back and beat the Nazis. And this audience was saying, escape, escape.
And just that, the kind of difference that you're talking about, that debate, what are they going to do? It fooled me. It fooled me.
Okay. I like
the picture. You've used this line on me a couple of times. Audiences are going to like this picture. All right. That's what's going to happen with this
one. Small disagreement.
All right.
We split our votes on Victory, the thriller starring Sylvester Stallone, Michael Caine, and a wartime soccer game. I vote no. I thought the movie was made up of predictable ingredients, but Gene liked the movie's rousing conclusion. He votes yes.